So I would like to provide you with an update on our typhoon Buchoy and its possible effect to our country. So Buchoy is the second tropical cyclone that ever arrived in the area of responsibility. And you can see the satellite image. Actually, this is the newest satellite receiving facility of PAGASA. This is from the satellite of Korea. And we could see the animation of this satellite showing the entry of the severe, actually, it is a typhoon and it entered the Philippine Air Responsibility yesterday at 2 p.m. And it was moving at 30 kilometers per hour speed towards Taiwan. Next slide, please. So, next slide. This is just the consensus of average forecast drops by the different international center. And we could see that they are actually most all of the warning centers are having a forecast drop of the typhoon moving towards Taiwan and then it will recur. Next slide. And the forecast drop of PAGASA is shown. And actually, this typhoon Buchoy is, as of 3 p.m., is around 700 kilometers east of Calayan. And it has intensified further. It has around 210 kilometers per hour maximum sustained winds and the gustiness of 240. So this is still a typhoon because for our category of super typhoon, it must be more than 220 kilometers per hour. It's still intensified, but yet it is still a typhoon and it is threatening the Taiwan area. Fortunately, our country will not be really affected by the strength of the wind except for our Agawis Islands. That's the reason why we have issued the tropical cyclone warning signal number 1 over the Batanes group of islands. And it is expected to have to feel the strength of wind of 30 to 60 kilometers per hour for the, within the next 36 hours. So maybe it's 3 p.m. It was issued this morning at 11 a.m. So it will be now less than 36 hours. They are expecting to have this 30 to 60 kilometer per hour wind strength. So what would be the effect of this typhoon over the Philippines? Next slide, please. These are just the observed rainfall. What we are having right now are rainfall due to the thunderstorm activity that we are experiencing every day over Visayas and Mindanao. Malaybalay had a rainfall of more than 100 yesterday, and this is just due to the thunderstorm and the tropical convergence. So, next slide. These are the observed rainfall for the past 5 days. These are the stations which have received more than 100 millimeters of rain for the past 5 days. This is not yet due to the typhoon Buchoy. Next slide. This is to show you the expected rainfall to be expected on, I think this is Friday morning and Friday afternoon. So expect the western sections of the Philippines, particularly those in the Mindoro area, to be affected by moderate occasional heavy rainfall. Next slide. And we will be in Metro Manila, we'll be expecting moderate to heavy rainfall also on Saturday. So this is the one that we need to prepare for, the moderate to heavy rainfall over the western sections of Luzon, including NCR, by the weekend, by Saturday. Next slide. These are just predicted rainfall using the WARF model and the Global Spectral Model. The one on the left is actually a conservative estimate, but on the right, the WRF that the PAGASA is running is more on the exaggerated estimate. But we should look into the extreme to be prepared. Next slide. And these are the stations which will receive this more or less the higher rainfall. So Palawan and somewhere in Lawan has about high number or more rainfall to be expected on tomorrow, today and tomorrow. Next slide. And this will be for the next day. That will be Thursday morning up to Friday morning. Let us focus on the output on the right, which is the WARF model. So you can see the yellow patches. These are the areas which will receive the more concentrated rainfall. And this is on the western section of the country. Next slide. And this is the estimated amount of the rainfall expected. So it is over Palawan area, which will be receiving the heaviest amount of rainfall. Next slide. And this will be on Friday to Saturday. So this is, as you can see, the Mindoro area is really expected to experience the heavy rainfall as well as southern Luzon, including Metro Manila. So expect Saturday to be rainy for us, and this is true to the Habagat, which is enhanced by typhoon Lochoy. Next slide. So what to expect? Lochoy is expected to exceed the Philippine area of responsibility by Friday morning up to about noon time. And we will be experiencing light to moderate rains starting today and tomorrow, but towards the weekend, we will be expecting moderate to occasionally heavy rainfall. Saturday is the most extreme rainfall estimate that we have, so let's prepare for Saturday. And this is due to the enhanced Habagat by Typhoon Lochoy. Next slide. So, of course, we need to prepare for some flash floods and landslides over the western coast of the Philippines, particularly over Bataan, Zambales, Pangasinan, and Benguet for landslides, because this is a mountainous area and it is expected that moderate to heavy rainfall will also be experienced over this mountainous area. Gale warning is issued this morning to the northern seaboard and eastern seaboard of Luzon because of the enhanced southwest monsoon. We have no public storm warning signal, tropical cyclone warning signal over the eastern Luzon. This is the reason why we have this gale warning. And our fisher folks are alerted not to venture over the sea because of this high waves that is expected from the monsoon. So, next slide. I think this is our information. But when we have heavy rainfall, we have, through the MGB, we have identified the, it should be given to you the areas which are prone to landslides and flooding due to the expected rainfall. So we are coordinating and we are working together with MGB and other agencies, and the areas which are susceptible to landslides and flash floods will be given to you in detail. Thank you very much.